Hello and welcome to What's the Difference? Accounts Payable versus Notes Payable versus Loans Payable. My disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College, the South Orange County Community College District, or Chapman University. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2019 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. So all three, between accounts payable, notes payable, and loans payable, all three of these types of accounts, these are all liabilities, meaning that these have to be repaid. However, each one of these liabilities is created from a different type of transaction. And each type of liability may have a different securitization, or what we call if it's being collateralized, meaning that if the amount is not paid, the company that is extending credit, they'll have different ways to go through and collect. When we're talking about collateralization, this really refers to a lender, or meaning the party who is extending credit, their ability to go after the assets of that borrower in terms of getting back their stuff, which would be in the case of equipment or the like. In terms of a seller's ability, or the person who's extending credit, their ability to collect, that's really going to be depending upon state law. So our first type of liability here is for accounts payable, and this is generally going to be resulting from purchasing items on account from merchants. And generally, this is not going to be collateralized, meaning that if the borrower defaults, then the person who just extended credit is not really going to have an ability to go after. Notes payable, in terms of purchasing equipment, vehicles, or other type of assets, really other than inventory, that's a note payable. And if the purchaser does not pay, that person extending the credit may be able to repossess the item. Again, that's going to be depending upon state law. And a loan payable is for borrowing money. And this is really going to be depending upon how that loan was written. Another type of liability that is not going to be covered here is a mortgage payable. Okay, so a mortgage payable usually refers to a loan against a particular property. So let's take a look first at accounts payable. Accounts payable is typically used for purchasing inventory on account. So the example I'm giving here is that if a company is a contractor and goes into Home Depot, Company X is a frequent purchaser of materials from Home Depot, and instead of having their workers need to pay on credit card every time, Company X asks Home Depot to sell the company goods on credit or on account. Company X will complete a credit application for HDI, and then HDI approves company and gives the company a certain credit limit. So the one I made up here was that the company can purchase up to $5,000 in HDI products on account. So whenever Company X purchases a product from HDI, this will be called on account. And then the transactions that will result from this will really be in the form of an account payable. And if the company defaults, meaning that they fail to pay Home Depot Inc., Home Depot may not be able to repossess those purchased items. And just in kind of looking at this, and I'll put this link in the bottom of my presentation, is that if we take a look here at this one particular example, this is how when Toys-R-Us went bankrupt, this is what happens. If you're a general creditor, meaning that you've been selling toys to these companies, what exactly happens? And so, you know, right over here, they all suffered huge losses as a result from this one particular customer of Toys R Us going bankrupt. So that's kind of the downside of accounts payable. Okay. And I have other videos where I talk more specifically about what can really be done before you start doing business. But it's more important for you to understand that right now, as you're beginning accounting, what's that difference between, say, an account payable, a loan payable, or a note payable? So let's take a look at an example. So on January 25th, 2020, Company X purchases $4,500 of inventory from HDI on account. So when you see that on account, it means that it's going to be, if I'm purchasing inventory, it means that we're going to be using that credit of accounts payable. So to prepare the T accounts and the appropriate journal entry, I'm receiving inventory, which is an asset. I'm going to show an increase of that inventory because it's an asset with a debit. At the same time, I am crediting accounts payable with a credit, or essentially that I'm increasing my liabilities because I ultimately will need to repay Home Depot Inc. this amount. So to put this in the form of a journal entry, I'm essentially just transferring down this into the different, basically to journalize the transaction. Once I've done this as in T accounts, this part becomes pretty easy, but that's what I would go through and do. And let's take a look at another example here. On February 14th, Company X pays HDI $3,000 in the amount owed from the transaction on January 25th. So what's gonna happen here is they're only paying $3,000. So we know that cash is decreasing. And what's gonna happen over here is that this accounts payable balance that was $4,500 from this right over here from January 25th, we're now decreasing it by $3,000 and we decrease our liabilities with a debit. So again, whenever we're doing this, these transactions, it has to make sense from both sides. So the remaining amount owed of this account payable was that $4,500 initial balance. There's a debit here for $3,000. So I owe $1,500. So over here, this is my transaction in terms of doing this as a journal entry. I am debiting accounts payable for $3,000 and I am crediting cash. Okay, and you may be asking, well, why didn't they pay the whole entire thing? You never know. Maybe there's a disputed item, maybe there's something else, but generally most people will pay their full amounts of the bills, but sometimes they don't. Okay, notes payable. What's a note payable used for? This is typically used for the purchasing of vehicles and equipment. It will generally have an interest rate and the borrower can pay for the items over a period of time. And in terms of a company doing transactions with notes payable, if it's a smaller type of entity, they may not be able to extend that credit because they may need the cash sooner. So what will oftentimes happen is that another party will come in and provide the funds in order for the purchaser to go through and to complete the particular transaction. But let's just take a look here at an example. So if Company Y purchases a truck to be used in its operations from Ford Inc., if Company Y defaults, among other remedies, FI would be able to repossess the truck if it has followed the appropriate state law guidelines. And again, this is going through and essentially how do we go through and basically securitize our transaction. So let's look at the example here. On March 15th, 2020, Company Y purchases a truck for $50,000 from Ford Inc. Company Y will make a down payment of 25% in cash and place the rest onto a notes payable. The notes payable bears interest at 10% and will be repaid in monthly installments for 60 months. Prepare the initial journal entry for the transaction. So here they're receiving equipment. So I'm going to go ahead and debit that equipment or that truck for $50,000. So that's my debit. I'm receiving a truck. Okay, so we're doing this for Company Y. So how are we paying for the truck? Well, I'm paying 25% in cash. So if I take 25% times the purchase price or $50,000, that's going to give me $12,500. So I'm crediting cash for $12,500 and the rest is being placed on a notes payable. So the amount that's going to the notes payable or a liability is going to be $37,500 or the purchase price of $50,000 minus the cash that was already paid. To do this as a journal entry, I would be debiting equipment here for $50,000, crediting cash for $12,500, crediting notes payable for $37,500. Remember, whenever you're doing a journal entry or whenever you are inputting items in terms of T accounts, your total debits must equal your total credits, which they do here. The last type of item is a loan payable. So when a company is borrowing money and has to repay that money with interest, this is called a loan payable. So on April 20th, 2020, Xavier Inc. borrows $100,000 from Trek Inc. The loan bears interest at 8% and will be need to be repaid 1 year from now. So if we're asked to prepare the journal entry in the T accounts, so over here, when we're borrowing money, this is what we call a loan payable. And the initial entry that we're going to be making over here, at least on April 20th, is here I am debiting cash for $100,000 because that's what I'm receiving. My credit, though, is going to be a liability, and this will be a loan payable. Okay, that's not an account payable, not a notes payable, because I have to pay. This really results from a cash loan given to me. So that's really kind of that important distinction. When I come over here to use this as a journal entry, I'm going to go ahead and debit cash for $100,000, which is right coming from that T account. And then I'm crediting loans payable. And remember, with my journal entries, it's really a translation of these two T accounts here. I'm just adding in a date and then I'm adding in a description. But a loan payable is when I'm borrowing money. Okay. A note payable is when I'm purchasing something like equipment or a vehicle, and an account payable is going to be when I'm generally going to be purchasing inventory for resale to my customers. So that's the difference between those three. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me at 1812cpa@gmail.com. Please do not forget to like and subscribe, and have a great one. Thank you so much.